Chemotherapy after surgery is decided by looking at the characteristics of that particular patient's breast cancer. Things like especially positive lymph nodes indicate that there's a possibility of microscopic cells circulating in that patient's system that at some later date may cause metastasis. One of the tests that we don't have, that needless to say would be great, is a test that tells us after primary therapy or after local therapy, that being mastectomy or lumpectomy radiotherapy, are there circulating tumor cells that have metastatic potential? There are many patients, even many with node positive breast cancer, from the past we know were cured by local therapy alone. But with various factors, namely hormone receptor negativity, positive nodes, larger tumors, and especially a higher number of positive nodes, indicate that there are cells in that patient's body that have metastatic potential that we have no test for. Patients often ask, well, can I get a PET scan and an MRI and a CAT scan and a brain scan and a bone scan and prove that I don't need chemotherapy? Unfortunately, none of those tests are sensitive enough to pick up the cells that will eventually cause metastasis. So that we're left with looking at large trials, large databases with different characteristics of patients' cancers, that is a low number of positive nodes or a high number of positive nodes or HER2 positive or HER2 negative, etc., and running different trials with different adjuvant therapies. And in those trials that are often randomized, that is, neither the patient nor the doctor picks the treatment, but randomized between, for instance, an older treatment and a newer treatment, and in those large settings, when we have positive data, it shows us that in a particular group of patients given a new treatment or a different treatment, their long-term cure rate is higher than the older treatment. The dilemma continues to be that even though we know group A may be better than group B, there are obviously people in group B that did not benefit because they might not have needed treatment in the first place. And then unfortunately, even patients in group A with the newer, better treatment that recur in spite of that treatment. What we continue to need is an individual test that determines whether a particular patient after their local therapy is destined to recur or not. I don't see that test occurring in the next 5 years, certainly, but one would hope in the next 10 years one might have that test so that many of the people we now treat with adjuvant chemotherapy, we would prove don't benefit by it and therefore we wouldn't give it.
Hi, I'm Dr. Jay Harness, and I want to share with you important information that I believe that every newly diagnosed patient with breast cancer needs to know.
I'm a breast cancer survivor.
I am a breast cancer survivor.
I am a breast cancer survivor.
And I want every woman to know
about personalized breast cancer treatment
and the genomic test.
A test that helps guide a woman and her doctor
to the best treatment options for her.
Pass it on.